Welcome, welcome, all are welcome to ShockaCon 2014 and the Wayward Girls School of Burlesque's third annual Burlesque show, featuring the Baroness Ruby Rouge, Miss Kitty Kilton, the one and only Susie Sketchman, Miss Cat Schrodinger, co-headmistress Penny Maple, and me, your hostess with the mostest, Luna L'Enfant. We also have some very special guests with us tonight from Charleston, West Virginia's newest burlesque troupe, the Charleytown Hellcats. But first, some shameless self-promotion. For those of you who don't know, Wayward Girls School of Burlesque does not discriminate against any race, religion, creed, gender or gender identity, sex or sexual orientation, body type, ability, or whether or not you're just a freaking hot mess. We have a spooky, kooky night planned for you tonight, our very special audience, and also a fabulous prize. If our kitten Leo Tuxedo will bring the raffle prize up here, we'll go over that in just a moment. If you haven't already been by Moonlit Artistry and bought your raffle tickets, they're only one for a dollar, six for five, or lucky 13 for 10. You can buy them during our set from the Fiend right over at the Renfield's table.
God.
Or Jason 3D.
Who cares about the Jasons?
He's a jackass. Hey.
You have the chance to win a pair of free pasties and a t-shirt and three buttons with our limited edition Halloween design created by the talented, super crazy sexy Mr. Glenn Brogan. We also have some lovely sugar skull glasses made by the ever enchanting Rose Winland. We have a couple of shot glasses, wine glasses. Yes, yes, my mind is on something else. A lovely necklace. Take that out and model it for him, Leo. Yes, isn't it gorgeous? We have a couple Jason beer cozies.
Yeah!
And a lovely Halloween scarf. Some lovely nail polish and eye makeup packet. And Liz Goldwyn's Pretty Things, a wonderful resource on all things classic burlesque and full of pretty pictures. Yes, that's the book, Leo. All right, so please try to get your tickets tonight with us. We will be doing a drawing at the end of our set, and we promised the Fiend we would give him some table scraps if he sold enough of our raffle tickets, so please help us feed the Fiend.
No!
Thank you, Leo. Well, here we are at a rock and roll Halloween show. So, our next performer is going to show you heathens just how evil rock and roll is. In just a moment. With the divine help of Project Biscotti, let's welcome to the stage Miss Cat Schrodinger.
Thank you.
boils and ghouls. Next up, we have, with their very first performance, representing the Charleytown Hellcats, with music courtesy of Funhouse, let's give another hand for Brittany Brutal and Calamity Jade. October 25th at the Blue Parrot, showing you some thrills and chills you won't want to miss. Now, what is it about those strong, silent types? The ones who make your heart beat fast without a single word? The ones who take you on interesting dates in the woods, at night, at abandoned camps by crystal clear lakes? One thing's for sure, Penny Maple's got a diehard, she is a diehard fan for men with masks and mommy issues. With music from those clean cut kids from Transylvania, the Renfields. Choreography courtesy of Miss Jamie Lee Renfield herself. Let's all machete a go go.
Thank you.
Lady Bathory possessing Ruby Rouge. Really, if there is a priest, rabbi, pastor, a Wiccan high priestess even, we're gonna need these gals for later. Performing burlesque can sometimes seem like herding cats. And that's never been as literal a case as it is for our next act. Performing to Leslie Hall's Cat Dancer, let's welcome to the stage Kitty Kilton and Kat Schrodinger. Walked the woods surrounding her home at night. It was her only permitted unsupervised time. If her brother Vincent had his way, she would never have any alone time. Dr. Brother had had great difficulty in convincing him to allow her these few hours to herself each night. Go after a trespassing camper one time with a machete and everyone loses their minds. She looked down at her empty hands with sadness. For she was not allowed to carry her machetes with her anymore. She sighed deeply. I suppose I should be thankful for being allowed these times to myself. Still, she felt like a prisoner, much like her dear sweet fiend. Her train of thought was abruptly cut short by the melodic sound of a dying woman's screams. She grew concerned. Had the fiend escaped? She instantly regretted sneaking him her chicken bones after dinner. She soon found the source of the screams. Although the woman was no longer moving, much less making any noise, the man looming over her body intrigued Jamie Lee. His long hair cascaded over his leather jacket. Blood dripped from his machete. Jamie Lee's heart skipped a beat. She was filled with an overwhelming curiosity. She had to see his face. She touched her own and hesitated. What if her mask scared him away? She'd never felt this way before. She didn't know what to do. Gathering up her courage, she stepped into the clearing. The man turned quickly when he heard her, machete raised, readying himself for another kill. Jamie Lee felt no fear. In fact, her heart swelled. He too was wearing a mask, one much like her own. Was his face disfigured beneath like hers? He paused and gave her a curious look, his machete slowly lowering. Can I touch your blade? She asked. He said nothing, only staring at her straight into her soul. My dear brothers took both of mine away, and I longed to hold one again, if only for a few seconds, she explained. Slowly, he held the machete out to her. I see you are a man of few words, she said as she approached him and grabbed the handle. Their fingers touched briefly, igniting a fire within her. He jerked back, as if he too felt the flames. The machete slipped from her grip and lay forgotten on the ground. She moved closer to the man. She knew she didn't understand this feeling, but instinctively, she had to close the short distance between them. Speechless, she looked up at him. He considered her for a moment before he finally spoke.
I am Jason 3D, he said roughly.
His voice sent waves of pleasure crashing through her body. She barely managed to whisper, my name is Jamie Lee. Their passion flared and their masks clashed in a fiery kiss. Nothing could end their passionate embrace. Nothing. Except...
No!
Her brothers. She tore herself away from him and cried, we will meet again, my dearest Jason, before running to her brothers. She wondered how long she would be grounded this time. Truthfully, she didn't care. She'd met her soulmate. The end. That was such a heartwarming story, and it just warms my cold, cold, cold heart. And wait, I'm forgetting something. Rise, my dear, and live again. Thank you so much to Jamie Lee Renfield and Jason 3D for allowing me to share their story. And thank you very, very much to Sherry Cheesecake and Dr. Herbert for helping us out with the reenactment. Up next, our performer is going to show you a very traditional form of burlesque with a not-so-traditional partner. Performing to music from Mr. John Colton, let's welcome to the stage, Susie Sketchman.
Night when the house is dark and you're all alone.
That was Susie Sketchman. She's certainly no doll. And she would like to give a great big thanks to Dave Rose of Cemetery Nights for her little companion. Now, friends and freaks, this next act is a little disturbing, so get ready for it. It's about this time the devil really wanted Ruby Rouge and thought her name was Christine. Bargained for. Big thanks to the Big Bad for that iconic song. First, Ruby Rouge just happened to sew ShockaCon Alien's new clothes and the panels for this lovely backdrop. This delightfully ghoulish view is courtesy of Mr. Chris Whittall. We can't thank him enough. He also painted the stained glass in our mausoleum. We also want to mention that these beautiful set pieces are here thanks to Mike McGrew, Johnny Carter, and Dave Rhodes. You can see more of their work and the work of Adam Edwards all throughout ShockaCon. Now, our next frisky performer is going through some life changes. She's turned into pure evil. She's gonna work it out on the stage to some Calabrese. So put your hands together for Miss Kitty Kilton. Yeah!
Inside.
how curiosity killed the cat. Let me find my wolf's thing. I'll just tell her it's catnip. Let's give another warm round of applause for Kitty Kilton. Enjoyed our time here at ShockaCon 2014. And let's give a round of applause for the bands we performed to tonight. Funhouse, The Renfields, Calabrese, The Big Bad, The Laser Beams.
Okay.
Tell me
and I'm forgetting some. Thank you, Project Biscotti and Jonathan Colton. I think that's all. Oh, Leslie Hall, Cat Dancer. How could I forget that one? All right. We love you all, and wait, what's that? Did you hear that? By the pricking of my thumbs, something wicked this way comes.
Aid, take us up the Maniac Mansion.
Applause
for
really throwing.
Thank you, everyone. Stick around for the Jasons coming up next.
Thank you.